How do you do? My name's Graham Murphy. I'm a product manager here at Tech Rentals. Today we're going to look at the Uvolle-VX. This is a corona camera. It's generally used to identify instances of corona in medium voltages and high voltage systems. Corona occurs when we have the breakdown in insulation. The items supplied in the kit by Tech Rentals, here's the instrument. We've got spare batteries, we have a charger with a power supply, we have a microphone for recording audio onto it. We've also got an adapter to allow you to move the information from the memory stick in the instrument across to the PC. And we've got a video out adapter and a strap to hang over your shoulder. This is the unit itself. We've got the displays hidden under here. Just to show you, we've got our various I/O options here. We plug a mic in there, power, external USB memory stick for copying the information across. We can also, this is how we access the battery. You flip this and replace them. There's a couple of spare batteries so we can get at least 8 hours of work out of it when you rent this. So let's have a look. This is the, always take the lens cap off before you use it. Invariably I forget to. Open it up. Turning it on is simply a matter of hitting this button. And the unit has turned on. There we go, it's turned on and working. Okay, we've turned the instrument on. This is a menu down the side. Now there's various options available here. We move around up and down the menu using these up and down keys. We simply hit this button here when we want to record, that button to take a photograph. This is a return key. Now what I'm going to do, the initial one here is the UV gain. Now you can see that it's flashing little spots of distortion, if you like, because we've got the gain up very high. Now if I want to bring the gain back, you'll see that they disappear, they come up, etc. So that's the UV gain. I hit enter there. I can come down here. This is the visible zoom. Enter. The UV zoom alters the size of the points it picks up. So in other words, if you're picking up a small image, you can actually make it a little larger. This here affects the color of it. This is the autofocus and manual focus. This is to load items we've previously captured. And then there's a maintenance menu down the bottom, which you probably won't need. So we'll just go and have a quick look at what it looks like if we pick up an image. We'll just demonstrate what it looks like when we pick up a bit of UV. If you light this, it's a quick way to test whether the instrument's working. Can you light the... lighter. Here we have an example of a UV output. Okay, now if I want to take an image of this, I can simply hit this button, takes a photograph, or if I want to record a video, I hit this button. It's now recording. You can tell that red button, red light here. Now I'll stop. All right, now if I want to look back at that, I come down to this menu item. And I push enter, wait a couple of seconds. It's loading the information out of memory and I can go HVR. This is today's year, month, day, and the last video there was this one here that I was recorded. And we can play it back. There it is there. Very simple instrument to operate. It's highly effective. The corona cameras are a really quick, easy way to identify the location of these faults. They won't give you a magnitude because the amount of corona is a function of humidity on the day and temperature, etc. But you can walk along and look at assets and you can very quickly identify where you've got problems. You then follow up with additional tests, for example, from a PD tester measuring the actual dB level in acoustically or electromagnetically. This is an example of measurements made in the field by this type of instrument. It's clearly visible where the issues are. You would follow up this inspection with a visual inspection of the actual insulators, etc.